Hey guys, today I want to walk you through how to organize your references within Zotero. So there's several different ways you can do reference organizing, so I'm going to share a system I have for how I use each of these different ways. Before I get started, I want to let you know that if you're working on a research paper using Zotero, you can grab my scientific research paper checklist to make sure you're walking through all the steps you need to do to write and publish your research paper. So here you can see we are in my Zotero right now, and I created this using the Zotero connector. So I went to Google Scholar and I looked for all of the papers related to steroids and eye mobility, which is what I did my PhD work on. If you don't know how to use the Zotero connector, check out the video above. It's going to teach you how to auto-populate this list just like I did. So this is generally where we get to, and then we leave it and we say, okay, I have a bunch of references. I'll just, you know, kind of search and try and figure out what my references were. So I want today to teach you, once you've imported your references in, a system to be able to organize your references so that it's easier for you to be able to find the one you're looking for later on. So the first step to organizing your references is to create a collection. So you can see here, I generally name my collections based on the topic that I'm working on. However, in this case, I named this a little bit differently because I have another steroids and eye mobility section, and this is specifically a test one that I wanted to do to show you. So this is my steroids and eye mobility Google search. So these are all the ones that came in off of a Google Scholar search. So that's the first way that I organize things. And I use new collections as a way to organize fields. So this may be steroids and eye mobility. Another work that I did in my PhD was looking at obesity and lipids. And so that, if I was looking at references for that, I would actually put it in its own collection and not in this collection combined with this. So that's how I organize my different fields that I'm studying, is through these different collections. I don't want to say projects, because in this case, steroids and eye mobility, I had about four different projects that worked on it that all pulled from the same general literature. So instead I say fields to kind of clarify that. So then the next thing you can do is you can have sub-collections. If you right-click on your collection, you can add a new sub-collection. So with the sub-collections, those are going to be my major themes. And so in this case, my major themes is steroids used for in combination with LC, IMS, and MES, and then steroids that are just used as standalone methods. So I've created one sub-collection there. I'm going to create a new one, standalone. Okay. So now what we can do is I can sort through these and put them into their appropriate places. So a lot of these are actually my own papers, which is interesting. But if you don't know what you want, you're obviously going to need to read through these papers and try and figure out what goes where. So obviously you can see these two here say LC-MS or LC-IMS in it. So I know I can go ahead and move these into the LC-IMS-MS. So you can easily just drag and drop. And now they're included in here. They're also still included in here. So your main collection is going to have all the ones that are included in that sub-collection. But then I can go to my sub-collection and specifically look at these. This is super helpful if you're trying to write a review to make your sub-collections your major themes within your reviews. So what are your headings going to be throughout your review? This is a really helpful way to do this, and it's how I did it for my review that I wrote on this topic, which you can see is right here. And so here's another one that I did that was actually LC-IMS-MS. And then here's a couple that I already know are just IMS. So if you use control and click, you can select multiple of these at the same time. And so here's a GC one. So I could change my LC-IMS-MS to be just chromatography IMS-MS, or I could actually create a different category for GC. And so I can just drag all of these into the standalone. So now I have my major themes. I have three papers under LC-IMS-MS, and I have five papers under the standalone method. So that's my major themes for this specific field that I'm looking at. So the next thing I want to do is use tags to tag everything by a specific topic. So if one thing falls into multiple different topics, I'm going to give it multiple different tags. So tags are really easy to create. So I can go to any specific paper and start writing out the tags for this. So in this case, I'm going to include steroids. I'm going to include anabolic steroids, and I'm going to include FAMES and IMS. So that's four. If I actually went in and read the paper, I might go through and include some more tags based on what the paper actually says. But right now I'm just going off of the actual titles themselves. So if I go to the next one, I want to add in tags for this. So I might add in metal adduction. That's a specific topic in this field. Again, steroids, I'm gonna add in TWIMS. TWIMS is the type of ion mobility I used. I'm gonna add in IMS because it obviously has IMS included in that. So those are the main four tags there. And here I might go in and add CCS, IMS, steroids. So I could keep going through this. In something like this, I would probably add in LC, IMS, MS. This is a theme, but it could also be a tag. So if I want to be able to quickly sort through anything that talks about LC, IMS, MS, I can have that there, even if something doesn't quite fit under the theme. And then I can also do steroids. I could do steroid isomers, because that's specifically focused on those. And then I could do IMS, because obviously it includes IMS. So you can include all of these different topics within these, and you can go through and do all of these by this. The other thing I will say I like to do is I like to add a review topic. So here I would add in a review, just to tag this specific paper as a review. I know it's a review because I wrote it. So now we have several different tags for a lot of our different things. The other thing that's really nice is you can actually see your tags in this bottom left over here. So if I want to see all of the papers that I've tagged as CCS, I can just click it and it'll show up here. It will also then only show the tags that are also in here. So if you wanted to separate those by CCS and steroids, obviously there's only one in here right now, but you can click both of these to continue to filter out. And then you can just uncheck them to go through. So I think I tagged several things as steroids. And something that is worth noting is like here, this steroids is actually considered something different. So capitalization matters here. So you want to make sure you're maintaining the same capitalization. So if I go into steroids here, you can see I have five different things that I've tagged. And then let's say I want to only see the ones that talk about steroid CCSs. Now that's going to only appear with this one. If I click off the CCS, it's going to take me back here. And then I can go into something like LC-IMS-MS. And then if I want to see a review that talks about steroids, LC-IMS, MS, then I would just click this review and I get my review here. And so this is what I like, why I like to have a review as a tag. So I can easily just find all of my reviews to be able to quickly access a lot of the background information. You can also always type in a tag here. So if I type in the tag name here, it can be easier to find if you have a lot of tags available. The other thing you can do is you can actually change the color of your tags. So if you want to be able to easily see the colors while you're just looking at your papers, you can right click on any tag and assign it a color. And so let's say we want this to be blue and hit set color. So now you can actually see that tag here in blue. If we do the steroids, let's assign it a color and let's do green and set color. So now you can see here's all the greens and the blues are also tagged. So this is an easy way for you to be able to identify the different topics within a paper if you're just looking at it visually. If you want to remove a color, you can right click on your tag again, hit assign color, and then just hit remove color. And so that's going to take away that color. So that's an easy way to be able to visually separate out all of your topics. The last way to organize between your different references is to be able to use the related feature within Zotero. I mainly use this for papers that I know either came from the same research project or are in a series with each other. So I know that these two papers, because they're my own, are actually a series with each other. So this paper was done first, and then this paper references that paper. So what I want to do is create a related tag that combines those two together so I can easily remember which ones are when I fully put this out. So if I go to one, I can go to this related section and then I'm going to add a related. And so it's going to bring up my entire library again and I want to click the other one that's related to that. And so I can click, okay, so now it's going to show up related there. But then also if I go in here, the other one's going to show up related. So now those two are linked together. So I can easily, if I have a ton in here, I can easily go to the related categories to see those that are generally by the same authors within a specific research project or steps along a research project. It makes it easier to follow that path instead of constantly looking for different people. You can also always sort by any of these categories. So I can sort by title or creator. So I can sort by the author and stuff like that if you want to be able to link all of these together. So you can see my papers are all here. These aren't all of my papers, obviously, but the ones I did on steroids are there. So those are the main ways that I organize between all of my different things. I use collections to determine the field. I use subcollections for themes. I use tags for topics, and I use the related to connect between papers for the same project. The next thing I want to do is show you how to actually organize information for a single paper. So within each of my things, the one thing that I always want to do is put in the PDF there. That makes it really easy to be able to organize and look at it so that everything's within Zotero. So I can just drag it and drop it onto the actual title. So it's going to drop it under here. So now I can always double click on this and I have access to it, to the PDF within here. So that's an easy way so that you don't have a whole folder for your PDFs. They're all controlled within here. And then the next thing that I do is as I'm reading through or going through this, the next thing you can do is add in notes. So you can add in a note here giving, usually I'll give a synopsis for it so that it's easier to be able to search later on, or if I have keywords or things I want to relate to it. You also have bullet points here and other things you can do here to organize your topics. If you're, you know, thinking through your discussion or you're linking between different things, you can always be talking in here and then you can link to a reference or include a related tag. So if you're talking about, if you wanna say, you know, this was the first step to metal adduction standalone. So let's say I have a note here saying that these CCS are in good agreement with this paper up here, this one. So what I can do is actually link that. So I can have a related here because I'm talking about that paper and then I can link it here. So now I know what I'm talking about in here. And if I need to link more, you can add more in here. So now if I'm looking through this, I can easily see down here which papers I'm referencing. And this is a good way to start creating the connection points that may be in your discussions or in your reviews by using this method. And so then you can always come back. So here's the note, here's my PDF, and then these are the things that got pulled in with Google Scholar. The final thing I want to talk about is your duplicate items. So in here, you can see that these two are duplicate items. And so you have two options here. You can right click and merge these items. So this is going to combine the two items together because you know that they're duplicates. Or I could click one and move it to the trash. So if I don't want to make sure that I didn't lose anything that's between those, so I can merge those. And I'm going to choose the most recent one as the master. And so now these two are merged together. So you can see that that full text got brought in. So I could probably throw that in the trash because it's probably the exact same thing. You can also go under your duplicate items up here. And you can see that I have a lot of duplicate items because I have two different collections that are on the same topic. If you're going by field for different collections, then all of your things should be under a single collection and you shouldn't need it under multiple collections. But because I have this as a test one, because I didn't want to mess with mine that's up here, I wanted to make sure that you can see I have a bunch of duplicate items in here. So I could easily go and merge all of these together easily through here to make sure that you're not keeping references in different places. And those are the basics for how I organize my Zotero. Again, if you're working on research papers, go ahead and download my scientific research paper checklist so that you can easily walk through what you need to be doing to work on those research papers and move them forward. I look forward to seeing you in the next video.